Running a Fever, episode 127. This is my review of Michael Matthews' Bigger, Leaner, Stronger. And once again, we're cross-posting from my YouTube channel, Southern BookTube. So check it out at southernbooktube.com, and it'll of course always be on runningafever.com/YouTube.
I woke up this morning, year round for my shoes.
Welcome to Southern BookTube. In the world of bodybuilding, knowledge is power. Bigger, Leaner, Stronger, The Simple Science of Building the Ultimate Male Body by Michael Matthews is an attempt to provide a more or less complete reference for diet and exercise, specifically for men intent on becoming physically lean and muscular. The edition reviewed is the paperback, second edition, published by Oculus Publishers. Bigger, Leaner, Stronger is divided into sections. Section 1 and 2 present big picture philosophical concepts. Section 3 is on nutrition. Section 4 is a detailed training guide, and the remainder cover supplementation and some summary and marketing notes. The biggest advantage Matthews has is his research. His assertions are supported by reference to scientific studies. His explanations include why one study is different from another and may have different applications. His bibliography is extensive. The text of the book covers some 274 pages, followed by a 37-page bibliography. Some detriments include the typical cheesy before and after pictures with puffed out bellies in the former and dehydrated twisted torsos in the latter. Along with this is a lot of marketing material for his other products. The language can be colloquial, but is not offensive, nor does it distract significantly from the clarity of the message. The nutrition section includes advice mostly on weight and body fat control, but does not neglect the importance of micronutrients. Though not a complete diet reference, it is useful as a starting point for building a comprehensive plan. Section 4 on training offers a number of alternatives to choose from, including 3-, 4-, and 5-day plans to distribute muscle group work for the best results for the reader's particular schedule. Matthews details the reason behind the order of exercise, why warm-up sets are useful, and provide some basic descriptions of the exercises, and even a few diagrams. Links to videos provide external content with even more detail. My best endorsement of this book is that I still refer to this section on a frequent basis, as I am using it almost exclusively as the blueprint for my weightlifting routine. Supplementation is a $28 billion industry, and no comprehensive guide could fail to address the topic. Supplements are attractive to our easy results consumer mentality. After all, drinking a milkshake is a lot easier than committing to months of workouts day after day. This is why there's a professional sport called bodybuilding. Matthews admits that supplementation is not necessary to build a lean, muscular body, and goes as far as to say he prefers whole foods. This reverse psychology makes him seem more credible. Like many bodybuilding gurus, Matthews has a line of supplements which, like all such products, claims to have the support of scientific research. But the evidence in the reading of Bigger, Leaner, Stronger at least shows that he has the ability to assess and present such research. The bottom line is that Bigger, Leaner, Stronger is a good reference for the amateur bodybuilder. I continue to use it and find it to be very valuable. I present a lot of Matthews' ideas in my fitness podcast, Running a Fever. I'll provide links to that and additional resources related to this review below. Thanks for watching Southern BookTube. Y'all come back now.
But you know about it, that he don't walk in
This is the Padua Podcast Network. PaduaPodcastNetwork.com.